We are so happy to see you here. We are so happy to be able to have a live audience for our performances. It has been a long couple of years. And thank you for being here. Thank you for supporting your children in them wanting to do music and enjoy music. And we can't thank you enough. And we're just really excited to share with you the things that we've been working on over these last few months. And I guess the best thing to do is just sit back and enjoy. I'm going to call for the middle school chorus now to come up and get on the risers, and we will begin with the middle school chorus.
Thank you.
So we have a little bit of a transition to make here as we clear risers in the piano and bring on the band. So we're coming back soon.
Hi. I'll take this off so you can actually hear me. Hi. This is the seventh grade band. They are going to start with a piece of music that was designed by the composer to be the soundtrack for an athletic event. It's called Game Day Battle. This next piece that they're going to play has two movements. So there's a first section, and then there's going to be a moment where it looks like we stop. Or not, there's another section. So this piece is called A Prehistoric Suite. Paul Jennings wrote this, is inspired by dinosaurs, prehistoric scenes. The first one is called The Gladiator, inspired by the Stegosaurus. And then the second part that we're going to play is called The Battle, which is inspired by, I think, Tyrannosaurus Rex and some other. Whatever, some plant eating dinosaur with the team.
Thank you.
the instructions in their music for that part, right, it may have been a little bit confusing, saying play random notes, start low and soft, and then get louder and faster. I think it's supposed to be the dinosaurs beating each other. I don't know. As a compositional device, I think it's something to be desired, but it is fun to do. So this last piece that we're going to play, I'd originally planned to play something else, but the students semi-rebelled and said that they wanted to play something different. So we're going to play Mechanical Monsters, which is a piece of music, I think, inspired by, like, bad horror movies and cinematic monsters that do things. So they really like it. It involves banging on the music stands. John gets to play a brake drum and I think that's the bottom of a mic stand. Anyway, it's fun. Mechanical Monsters. This piece is based on that, and it is also based on an eight-note melody motif that goes like this. Right, so straight from 1200 chant music comes this Dies Irae theme, Day of Wrath, and to tell this particular story, the composer uses that idea over and over again, upside down, backwards, turned around different ways. It's really fun.
Thank you.
opposite of that as you could possibly be. Midnight Sky. It's a piece inspired by solitude, inspired by starry night, quiet, all the sorts of things that are sometimes really hard for eighth graders to do. Quiet in solitude. Unfortunately, I don't really have anything else to say about this piece. That's pretty much all there is to it. It's lovely. We're going to play it, and the percussion is still setting up. My students tell me my jokes are terrible, so I'm not going to do that. Really, they've been telling me this all day. All day. I tried a joke this morning. You good? Okay. Next piece, this last piece that they're going to play is a medley of two Irish folk tunes, Oh Danny Boy and Star of the County Down. It has lots of really loud drums at the end, which I think might be very good. They're still moving a few things. So I'll tell you, just in case you're wondering, it says in the program, this is Celtic Aran Dance number 2. There is a Celtic Aran Dance number 1. I know for sure there's a Celtic Aran Dance number 3, and there might even be a number 4. So Michael Sweeney, our composer, found the winning formula, but he kept going.
Roger, and Roger and I wanted to come up here because you may have heard David Powelson is going to be departing U32 after this year, and so we'll get to the thunderous applause for the work that he has done here with us over the last few years, six years. 6 years, including a pandemic, which is much longer. And I will say, David has been, I can't even speak to the amount of help he has been to our department, to our students, to the district level of music and the arts, and to me personally as a colleague, and just really like, I'm gonna really miss being on a team with you. So I wanna make sure that we acknowledge this tonight. Do you wanna add anything?
Yeah. I will, but I'll keep it short because I'm gonna start crying if I don't. It's really been a fabulous experience to get to work with David. He's just all the things that you want in a team. Organized. Actually, as Ann said, there's a lot of parts of the school that probably wouldn't function without David. He's a Canvas coach, he's an IC coach. Those things have nothing to do with music. And he does everything. It's just been a delight. I know that we count him not only as a colleague, but a friend. David is taking his expertise in organization and caring about schools and will be the assistant principal at Williamstown School, and they are so lucky. They have no idea yet how lucky they are. And yeah, I'm gonna stop because we're really gonna miss David. So.
Thank you.
thank you very much. Before we play our, we have one piece that has four different movements in it, and we won't stop in between. So I just wanted to say, I promise I'll be quick. It's so nice to see you here, and I know this is the first time you've been able to come in and watch your kids perform, at least on the U32 stage. And this is just the beginning. And I am so excited to know your kids and watch them as we continue together through the years making music, and you'll see the progression. And it's really, it's satisfying, it's interesting, and you'll get to know all of these groups as you go. So parents, caregivers especially, welcome to U32, finally. So this next piece, Serendipity Suite, it's, like I said, it's four different movements. We'll pause in between, but let's save the final applause till the end, if you can remember that. We've got a fiddle tune to start off. We've got sort of a funky cello feature in Cello Pudding. We've got a beautiful slow movement that features some of our violinists. And then the final movement, you'll know, because it's a bass solo. Enjoy. Thank you.